Hello class, because of this weather disruption yesterday night and today morning, we had some technical problems and I could not go online. So I am recording this video to help you, follow the class or rather do the exercise that I have given you today. The thing that I have given today is mainly questions. So just to help you understand what type of things you would be facing and how to prepare yourself for that. The most important thing I would like to tell you is I would be giving you this type of questions repeatedly and discussing them so that you can understand the questions and you can prepare yourself, because just going down and suddenly facing a question and then preparing it in your mind and answering them will not provide a very high performing answer. Rather, getting the questions, understanding what type of questions you can have and preparing for them beforehand will always be an added bonus, will be an edge over your competitors. So there are two type of HR questions that can come up. Those are neither just questions about what we always practice about why you are fit for the job and all those stuff. Questions are changing these days. People are asking you much more focused questions, and those are the things that we are going to discuss today. So I have sent you already, or to some of you I'll be sending these questions. One bunch is behavioral interview questions and another bunch is education based questions, and I have given you as a test assignment so that once you answer them, it will also be marked on that. So besides that, you are also preparing something for your whole life. And why are behavioral questions asked in interview? And here is a little bit of answer that I have written down, because they are not on something concrete that we can ask anybody. Maybe I can ask you that how good are you in communication, but you may have some answer, but you may have no proof to give for you. But if I ask you these type of questions and you answer very fluently, that means you prove that you are a good communicator. At the same time, you prove some other qualities also. And they are not definite. There are no definitive answer. Each can be a wrong answer, each can be a right answer. What you are answering, how are you answering it, and what are the steps that you are following, that is more important. That gives the interviewer a view into you as a person, your character, your personality, your strengths and weaknesses. The interview gets to know that. And as a result of that, these questions can be a little bit different, little bit difficult. It gives a insight into your mindset, and as is given here, and also gives an idea about your priorities and your values in the workplace. What you are outside the workplace is not our matter. What you do when you are inside the workplace, what type of value you give, that is what these questions will answer. So first question that we have is, tell me about the most recent project you work on. What were your responsibilities? Now, by project, they are including all type of things, whether you have done any class project, any semester project, or you have done a final year project or any other experiments, prepared for your seminars and done a project there. So what was your responsibility in that project? What type of things you did? And to answer such a type of question, if you have already worked even in a part time or a small stint, you have to prepare your answer in that way. What project you were in, what type of responsibilities you have. Try to be as precise and as truthful as possible. And when you are structuring your answer, you have to talk about the situation, which situation gave rise to what the project is, or it was a order or something like that, and you decided to work on that. So what was the situation and what was the responsibility that you took or that you were given? Why and what was the situation that gave you this type of task? What exactly was the task? What were you expected to do? What were the actions that you took, step by step actions, and what were the results that you got? Maybe initially you got something wrong, and then you traced back your steps and you found out the mistake and you rectified yourself and got back to the results. So this is called the start technology, and use the start technology to answer the situation or the to answer your responsibilities in a very precise way. What is the situation? What was the task? What was the actions that you took? What are the results? Let us move on to the next question. Describe a time when you were able to improve upon the design that was originally suggested. It sometimes happens that you are not exactly following orders. So when you are not exactly following orders, there must be something. Again, you should be telling us in the same format, why is it that you have done what you have done? What was the situation that forced you to improve or change the design that was originally suggested? And when you decided, what were the steps that you took? Did you take permission and did you just decide to do it a little bit and then approve and then take the permission? Or maybe you did not take the permission even then, you just went ahead with the action, and then before the results were to be submitted, you did something. So go ahead and use the same formula to talk about the result, to talk about this situation. Next is, tell me about the project you are most proud of and what your contribution was. Now, when such a question is asked, and the interviewer asks these questions because he or she wants to listen attentively to what you are doing. One or two sentences gives an idea of what you would be saying for most of the questions, but this is something which everyone is very eager to hear about because they are reading your character. They want to know, they want to explore out that what sort of tasks you enjoy, because they want to know whether that type of task is conducive, is applicable, is right for their work environment, and whether you will become better or rot away when you come to their organization and work. So they are actually seeing if you are a perfect fit, if you are a good fit, not a perfect fit, at least a good fit, better than most, that type of fit. So they want to know whether you can fit in properly by understanding what project. When you talk about this project, you can go back 2, 3, 4 years, even 5 years. Don't go back farther than that, because as a student, 4 years before, you were just in the 12th standard, and after that you have learned different skills, you're applying yourself in a different position. So don't talk about something before your graduation. Within this time, what type of project you have taken, what you have enjoyed, what type of work or responsibilities you had, and why you are proud of what type of achievements you had. Next is, describe your production deployment process. Is the process you would be talking about what type of things you do to take action? Here comes the process that I taught you in goal setting. You have a definitive goal to do reach. You are breaking the and a time to finish it in, and you break them down into the time, take the time and break them down. Suppose you have to do it in 5 days, you try to plan it out to do it in 3 or 3.5 days, so that you have a cushion. If something goes wrong, you can rectify it, modify it and do it. So talk about your planning process, talk about the way you broke it down, talk about the execution process and how you completed it. Every step is important, and when you talk about these steps, you prove that you are a very methodical, systematical and very disciplined person. So that is most important when you are going for a job in a company. What you do, I mean, the end result may not be successful, but the process is very essential. Last question is, give an example of where you applied your technical knowledge in a practical way. So some sort of knowledge, suppose as a civil engineer, you have lots of theoretical knowledge, a little bit of practical knowledge, but lots of theoretical knowledge about soil testing. So now you learned all those things, and then you applied it, and what type of steps you took to apply them and actually reach your result, that is what they're expecting. You know that this is the process, they know that this is the process, but they are asking you to categorically spell it out one by one, don't just stop and think that, my God, they are asking a stupid question. They are asking a stupid question because they want to know actually what you do, because not everyone does all the steps that is necessary. And if you jumped a step, or if you got something theoretical, but even then your practical teacher had, or when you had done your practicals, you had found that that particular step was not necessary, it would save time, you did that and you reached end goal. So that is what they are asking from you. What type of technical knowledge you actually applied and got result? You have a connection between your education and your behavior and your results. So these are the things that makes you a complete person. You don't allow any of the things to go to waste. That is important. So that is what you will be asked here. Next is, sometimes they ask you questions regarding your education. They don't ask you what your degree is. What are your technical certifications? So you're not just talking about the BTEC degree, whether you have got some other certificates, whether it is directly related or indirectly related, a 1 month course, a 15 day course, a 15 day certification, everything is important. This is where you tell them about all the additional things that you have that can be very helpful for a job, for any job. Next is, how did your education prepare you for the job? So talk about certain important practicals or practically applicable things that you have been taught that you think is very much conducive to the job or to any job, and which has helped you really prepare yourself for the job. Or if it is something not directly related to the technical education, but something else that you have been taught, some management techniques, some communication techniques, some economical techniques, that has helped you learn something besides your technical education. So first one, you talk about all the technical certificates. Second one, you talk about additional education that will also prepare anyone for a job. Next come is, how do you maintain your technical certifications? Now, as a technical graduate, you should know that technology is developing and changing every single day. So what you have to do is, you have to get yourself updated. How do you get yourself updated? Do you get yourself a better degree? Do you go online and get yourself a certification? Do you just go to the YouTube and learn about the new things that you come across? What are the things that you do to keep yourself updated? Because technical certifications are a basic qualifier of something that you have. You have the basic knowledge. Are you developing yourself? Are you growing along with the growth that is going on in the industry? That is what they want to know. Next is, I'll enlarge this so that you can understand. Okay, so here they want to know about how would you rate your key competencies for this job? Besides the technical knowledge that you have, they want to know whether you have any of this or more than one of this. Whether you are a good team worker, whether you can take up responsibility, you are a responsible guy, you have commercial awareness of any certain things, you are aware of the economical aspect of it, you are a good decision maker, you have good communication skills, leadership skills, you are trustworthy and ethical, you are result oriented, you have problem solving skills, you have organizational skills. What are the other competencies? They do not mean about the technical competencies. competencies here? What are the other things that you learned, and what are the other things that you have tested yourself, done it yourself, and become better, or become better than any normal fresher can be? And last but not the least is, what are your IT strengths and weaknesses? Here I'll give you a pick that I have got. These are the IT strengths that they want to know, whatever field you are in. Have you some idea of coding? Have you some idea of communication, networking, time management? If you are not from the IT or computer science sector, you won't have these three things, but you may have time management. So talk about that. If you are from the not from the computer sector, but you are ECE or EEE, you have some ideas of communication or some ideas of network. I am sure ECE guys have enough ideas of communication. So talk about the communication part of your IT skills that you have. If not, if you have some ideas about networking, talk about networking, and computer guys can talk about any one of them or more than one of them. So these are how the education jobs are going to be, questions are going to be answered. They don't want your they don't want to know about just your degree. You may have different other things, or you may have gone online and taught yourself a certain thing. I know many of you have learned digital marketing. Many of you have tried and understood traffic generation. Some of you have understood social media growth or social media marketing. So talk about those things. So even if you do not have technical certificates about the real certificates, you may say that you have gone ahead and pursued the particular thing. You have not taken a certificate, maybe it was expensive and it was beyond your reach, so you have gone ahead and learned the things. You may be in a position to showcase some of the things that you have received, some of the articles or some of the course materials that you have received, and you can talk about that. As I said, not all the questions are directly related to your technical background. Some of the questions are focused on a different area, so go ahead and answer these type of competencies also with example. Don't just say I have communication skills. Say about I have been doing such and such things, and I realize that I have good communication skills. I have been able to really go ahead and work on this particular field and develop myself there. I can take up responsibilities because when there was such and such thing, maybe some project or some fest or some other things, I had taken the entire responsibility of certain thing, and thereby I have learned that I can be given lots of responsibilities, and I have tried to utilize whenever extra time I had to develop on this to become a more responsible person. So talk about the other skills that you have: problem solving skills, result oriented skills. How you reach a particular goal is not important. The goal has to be reached. That has always been your focus. So talk about these things so that you can go ahead and impress your interviewers in these particular sectors. Both of the tests will be going to you in your in its own time, and you can refer back to my videos, but I'll not be giving you these datas. Refer back to my videos and write down the answers. 5 marks question is not going to be very short. They have to be at least 7-8 sentences, or more importantly 250 words. So about a paragraph or so has to be written about each questions. Try to write it in as best English as you know. First write it down, or first speak about it, talk about it in your mind, or maybe loudly, and then write it down, and then go ahead, finish all the 5 questions, and then go ahead and correct yourselves. Don't just start away by correcting, editing yourself, because if you start editing in the first lot, you won't be able to finish the questions because you'll be doubting yourself. Go ahead and write down the answers, then correct yourself and give me as correct English answers as you can. Okay, so I'll be ending my video here, and if you have any more questions, just get back to me. I can prepare another video again and submit it to you.